found a brand new lover. You decided that I'm not your kind. So I pulled your name out of my Rolodex, and I tore all your pictures in two, and I burned down the mall shop where we used to go, just because it reminds me of you. That's right, that's right. You ain't gonna see me crying. I'm glad that you found somebody new, 'cause I'd rather spend eternity eating shards of broken glass than spend one more minute with you. I guess I might seem kind of bitter. You got me feeling down in the dumps, but I'm stranded all alone in the gas station of love, and I have to use the self-service pumps. Oh, so honey, let me help you with that suitcase. You ain't gonna break my heart in two, 'cause I'd rather get a hundred thousand paper cuts on my face than spend one moment with you. I'd rather rip out my intestines with a fork than watch you going out with another man. I'd rather slam my fingers in a door. Trying to say, darling, I'd rather have my blood sucked out by leeches, shove an ice pick under a tornado or two. I'd rather clean all the bathrooms in Mesa station with my tongue than spend one moment with you. Yes, I'd rather jump naked on a huge pile of thumbtacks, or stick my nostrils together with crazy glue. I'd rather dive into a swimming pool filled with avalanche razor blades than spend one more minute with you. I'd rather rip my heart right out of my ribcage with my bare hands and then throw it on the floor and stomp on it till I die. Then spend one more minute. With you.
Hello, Mesa. And greater Phoenix metropolitan area. And people who don't really live anywhere close to here but came anyway. Thanks for coming in, guys. Can we hear it one more time for Emo Phillips? Honestly, such a joy to be on the road with him. I would have invited him on this tour even if he didn't have those Polaroids. It would be, you know. Just been really great. That's really all we were gonna do tonight. I wanna thank y'all for coming out. Oh, we can do some more, I guess. Just 17 more though, and we're done. This next song features the piano stylings of our own Mr. Ruben Valtier. I was watching my TV one night when they broke in with a special report about some devastating earthquake in Peru. There were 30,000 crushed to death, even more were buried alive. On the Richter scale, it measured 8.2. And I said, God, please answer me one question. Why did they have to interrupt the Simpsons just for this? I was driving down the highway when all the traffic slowed to a crawl. There was a 12-car pileup, everybody dead. And I saw brains and guts and vital organs splattered everywhere, as well as my friend Robert's disembodied head. And I thought, poor Rob, I just had lunch with him. Horoscope for today. Yeah!
opposition in Jupiter's hands. The teachers bent over and spit a wheat face down in the mud. When did they shove a roll of that tape up your nose? One TV you find your test. Now I'm not taking time to photocopy it, but stay mildly to your boss's face.
Oh no!
Eat a bucket of tuna flavor pudding and wash it down with a gallon of strawberry quid.
Virgo!
All Virgos are extremely friendly and intelligent, except for you. Surprise today when you wind up with your head impaled upon a sin. That's your horoscope. Born's your horoscope for today. That's your horoscope for today. That's your horoscope. Born's your horoscope for today. That's your horoscope for today.
They may find it inconceivable, or at the very least a bit unlikely, that the relative position of the planets and the stars could have a special deep significance or meaning that exclusively applies to only you. But let me give you my assurance that these forecasts and predictions are all based on solid scientific documented evidence. And you would have to be some kind of moron and have to realize that every single one of them is absolutely true.
A big promotion is just around the corner for someone more talented than you. Leather is the very best medicine. Remember that when your appendix burst this week,
you're
ready for an unexpected trip when you fall screaming from an open window. Work a little bit harder at improving your low self-esteem. You stupid freak,
Sagittarius.
All your friends are laughing behind your back.
Kill them.
Take down those naked pictures of Ernest Borgnine than you got hanging in your neck.
Capricorn.
Those stars say that you're an exciting and wonderful person, but you know they're lying. I read you and lock my doors and windows and never leave my house again. That's your horoscope. Born's your horoscope. Born today. That's your horoscope. Born today. That's your horoscope. Born's your horoscope. Born today. That's your horoscope.
Most of the love songs on the radio are about, you know, new love, fresh love, meeting somebody in a club, you know, which I can understand, that's exciting, but I don't think there are enough songs written about, you know, true love, mature love, you know, love that's stood the test of time. And now that I've been married for 85 years, I feel like I can be the voice of authority on this, so I'd like to impart some of my wisdom to you through this next song, which is called If That Isn't Love.
Yeah. I'm your shelter from the storm. You know I'll always have your back. I'll even let you warm your freezing hands inside my butt crack. I never get out my knee floor when Oprah is on. About your feelings, I try not to yawn.
every Sharpie of your face. And I don't wipe my nose on your couch, even though that's a super convenient place. I totally support every idiotic thing you do. And I almost never pretend you're someone else when I'm making out with you. And if that isn't had a love song, I feel like we need to keep balance in the universe and let the pendulum swing to the other side and do a hate song. And, I don't like putting that kind of energy out there, but you know, you gotta keep the balance in the universe. It's very important. And this song is in the style of one of my all-time musical heroes, Elvis. There's only one Elvis, Costello. This is called I'm So Sick of You.
Came on, I never needed anyone that's low on the food chains. Yeah, I just you got it, you.
We're gonna do a song called Don't Download This Song. And, I remember when I first wrote this, it was back in the mid-aughties. Did they ever come up with a name for that decade? I don't think they did. No, they're around 2005, 2006. And we did a video for this. Bill Plimpton, who's a wonderful animator, did a video for this particular song. And we tried to get it played on MTV. Now, again, this is 2006, so MTV wasn't really known so much for playing music videos at this point, but we thought, you know, why not? We made a video, let's try to get on MTV. So we submitted it and went through the whole screening process, and what we heard back was they didn't want to play it because we mentioned peer-to-peer file sharing sites, specifically Grokster and LimeWire and Kazaa, and they said we cannot air those names on a network. And I was like, really? Well, I mean, can't you just like bleep them out? And they said, yeah, I guess we could do that. So they did. And if you ever saw this video on MTV, which chances are you did not, but the few times it did air, you heard me say, file sharing sites like beep or beep or beep. So right now we're gonna play the dirty, unedited version of this song. Once in a while, maybe you will feel the urge to break international copyright law by downloading MP3s from file sharing sites like Morpheus or Grokster or LimeWire or Kazaa. But deep in your heart, you know the guilt would drive you mad, and the shame would leave a permanent scar. Cause you start out stealing songs, then you rob liquor stores and selling